Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. If you like this content, please consider subscribing and join all the lovely subscribers for this channel. Okay, not long ago, I did a video about sky replacements, and I have figured out some stuff I didn't actually mention in that tutorial. So if you did not see that tutorial video, it will be right up here somewhere, here, right up here in the card or down in the description below. And watch that video if you're interested in sky replacement, and then come back to watch this video, because in this video, I'll show you some neat tricks to make this look way better and more alive. Anyway, let's go to the editing suite. Let's go to DaVinci Resolve.
Here we are back in DaVinci Resolve and in the editing page. So the first clip we are going to have a look at is going to be this one, which is just, again, the fusion clip like last time. And in the previous video, I disconnected the lines here to rearrange the order of the inputs because they are not right from default. There's a faster way of doing this, of course. If you highlight your two medias and the merge node and push Control T, you'll invert that very fast. Just a quick tip. So let's go to the second one. A lot of people were asking me about doing movements on the clips and or maybe using a video instead of a still photo. I'll show you something else you can do with this. Again, back to Fusion. Inside the Fusion page, I will add a control spacebar, and then I'll use a transform. So I can transform the sky a bit here. So I'll move the sky up a bit. And let's see if we could. Actually, we'll just scale up this sky a little bit as well. So let's move it there, move it to the side, and then let's just push this animation icon, but remember to put the beginning at the first frame. And let's move around the end here. Then let's just move in the clouds a bit, something like that. So here we have a super quick animation done in Fusion. Okay, and for the next one, I have an animated thing, and I'll show you how to do some kind of a reflections into the water inside of Fusion. Okay, first we need to highlight our three notes here. Then Control C and Control V to paste them in, and just rearrange things a bit here. And I'll just add a merge. I'll push down Shift and just let go, and then I'll just connect this in as my foreground. So now we can't see anything. Okay, so let's go to the transform, and then I'll just reposition the foreground here. Whoops. Okay, just drag it down a bit, just like something like that. Yeah, something like that. And then I will just go and add a polygon tool, not two, just one. Delete number three, and then add that, and I'll pipe that into the blue in the merge too. Okay. And then I'll just quickly draw a shape around the water. I'll just do it super fast. There we go. And then we'll just go down here and select merge too. And in the merge too, we'll change it to screen in the apply mode. And now we have a reflection. And then in the blend mode, I'll just blend it down a bit, and the gain I will make a little list, something like that. And here we have it, a reflection of the sky. Okay, and for this clip, we're just going to have a quick look at that as well, just a little trick. So let's go to the Fusion tab here. And what we are having here is we're having the footage, which is this footage, and it's the exact same thing as we did with the photo, but instead of a photo, I have added a video. And this is just a super quick trick to make things match up a little bit better. Again, control spacebar to get the menu up, and then just go. Let's put in a color corrector. So now we can grate the whole footage together, give it some saturation, give it some contrast, and give it a bit of gain. Take down the lift a bit, and then mess around with all brightness. So this is just a way where you super quickly can add color to your footage without going into the color tab. You can do this inside of Fusion. Anyway, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on the channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.